Pinot Meunier is a red wine varietal, typically made as a blending component in champagne, but Bess have been producing a red wine out of Pinot Meunier for over 40 years. The beauty of Pinot Meunier is its ability to age and age gracefully and turn into something unique and special. So we've gathered some of the best palates in Melbourne today, and we're going to look at back vintage selection of Bess Pinot Meunier going back to the 1970s. It's definitely more delicate than Pinot Noir. It has a lighter colour and it doesn't have as much structure, but it definitely shows some of the age-worthy characteristics of Pinot Noir and the aromatics, and it shares some of that glossy savouriness of Gamay. But it does have this unique character that allows it to age well, and it improves as it gets older. And the name Meunier, for those who don't know, is reference to the leaves, which have this sort of white, dusty sort of fur on them that looks like flower or Meunier.
I really enjoy the 89. I enjoy those green notes that the wine was showing, and I think there's still a long way to go as well. It's just so fresh, so elegant, so fine, so in this case, I think feminine, so delicate that, yeah, I was really surprised.
We talked a lot about desiccated fruit and dried fruit and even wild grown fruit when we first looked at it. Now seeing this more dried meat, campfire and blown out candles. The fruit's still there, but there's all this other savoury and tertiary and earthy characters that kind of come up after a little bit of time in the glass.
It doesn't have the tannin structure of Pinot Noir, but it has a lot of flavour that kind of gives it a lot of persistence. That helps with ageability, and that's why it remains vibrant as it gets older. These wines have come from a vineyard, they've been bottled, and then as soon as they've been bottled, they've been kept in ideal conditions.
There's a duty of care with aged wine like we have. It would be an absolute travesty to have taken a bottle of 1976 and not have stored it correctly.
I mean, I'm just impressed how those wines actually aged, how they retain complexity, acidity, balance, nuances of flavours going through it. But more importantly, obviously, the purity of that vineyard.
The energy and freshness in that wine, just, I still can't get over. I've had a 1976 Pinot Meunier in which there's not much grown, very little produced as a single varietal, and it's harmonious, it's complete.
It's a good bottle.